name is Darren Mueller. I'm an Iowa State Extension soybean plant pathologist.
I'm Kirsten Wise. I'm an extension specialist for field crop diseases at Purdue University.
Hi, I'm Damon Smith, extension field crops pathologist for the University of Wisconsin-Madison. What we're looking at is soybean vein necrosis virus. Soybean vein necrosis virus is a TOSPO virus similar to tomato spotted wilt virus. This is the first TOSPO virus, however, in soybean, and we actually don't know very much about it. However, we do know that it is transmitted by thrips vectors.
So one of the things we want to talk about is the symptoms of this disease, and then also how to differentiate it from other foliar diseases.
The symptoms that we sometimes see include yellowing as well as some browning, along with eventual necrosis of the leaves or death of the leaves, and then eventually defoliation.
So it's very important that we get down into the canopy and look at the lesions that are on the leaves.
So the symptomology that we see with soybean vein necrosis virus can vary from this type of yellow vein syndrome, which we see early on. And sometimes you can even see the injury from the thrips vectors, which entails very, very small holes near the veins where they have fed. As the disease progresses, the symptom then becomes more of a brown or necrotic lesion on the leaves, which you can see here. The most severe symptom you're looking at here, where we have necrosis and chlorosis, which is browning and yellowing respectively of the leaf, and you can see the edges of the leaf are beginning to curl and shrivel up. In even more severe cases, the lesions will crack and fall from the plant, and eventually this leaf will defoliate from the plant itself.
It's very easy to confuse soybean vein necrosis virus with many of the other diseases that we see in soybeans.
Really, as you start digging, you can see all sorts of different types of spots. You can see little yellow spots in the lower canopy. You can see tattered leaves. You can see a whole array of things. And so one of the things you want to be doing is you want to notice where exactly are the leaves coming from. So you have a different type of symptom sometimes in the lower canopy than you would see in the upper canopy. And so we're going to sort of walk through what spots are that we see on different parts of the soybean plant.
In the lower canopy, we commonly see diseases such as brown spot. This is one that's in most Indiana soybean fields every year. It's got some small angular brown spots that can sometimes be surrounded by a yellow halo. And then as the leaves senesce, the entire leaf can turn yellow.
A second disease that we see is called bacterial blight, and this is shown here as, again, you have brown spots, so it can be confused with Septoria brown spot, but this is oftentimes seen in the upper canopy. And this is one where this is fairly young symptoms, where you see the black or darker lesion is followed by a yellow halo, and eventually it's going to grow to the point where you see some of these halos growing together, some of these lesions growing together, and then the leaves dropping part of that leaf tissue, so it has this tattered appearance. And so this is bacterial blight on soybean. Again, it's usually found in the upper canopy. So a third disease is downy mildew, and this is one that is a little bit different than bacterial blight or brown spot, because it doesn't usually have brown spots that are associated with it. And so this disease is usually a lighter green color, and it's usually fairly irregular shaped lesions. And so this shows up most likely in the upper canopy. It can be in the mid canopy as well. One of the best ways to confirm that it is downy mildew is to actually turn that leaf over and then use a hand lens. And I'm not going to use it properly, but you can put that hand lens over that lesion and you can see white growth. Sometimes in the morning, you can see that white growth without the hand lens or without any magnification. But it is one of the best ways to confirm it.
Now, there is another disease in this canopy that's known as frog eye leaf spot. And this is in the upper canopy, as you see here. And frog eye leaf spot gets its name because it looks like a frog's eye. It's got kind of a gray to brown center lesion that's surrounded by a purple or a dark halo. And this will be very small lesions that can coalesce into larger lesions on these trifoliates.
One of the other foliar diseases that you can see, at least while the leaves are still attached, is called sudden death syndrome. And this is very, very young symptoms of sudden death syndrome here, where you see the yellowing just starting to occur on the leaf. And as this disease progresses, you'll see there's actually some brown or necrosis that's also occurring. This will usually occur in between the veins. eventually, as this disease progresses, the leaves will drop and the petioles will remain.
At this point in time, we don't recommend management for this disease since we don't know the economic impact of the disease in soybeans.
There's much ongoing research. We understand a little bit about this. However, we're still going to look into cultivar resistance and also which vectors are important.